I'm sorry I kind of look gross, but happy Father's Day. So my dad is not too much of one for music. I mean, he enjoys music, like he's a human, but he's not like musicals like me and my mom, like doesn't care that much about music like that. But he did have one request. He's like, do you know me and Bobby McGee? And I'm like, I do not. He's like, I love that song. You should sing that song. And I'm like, okay. And it's a Janis Joplin song, and I never would have expected that from him, because the only songs I have known him to like are like Elvis and Johnny Cash. But yeah, so I found this sheet music for me and Bobby McGee, and I started kind of practicing a little last night. So forgive me, I'm gonna do my best, but it is by no means perfect. But I love you, Dad. Happy Father's Day. Oh, I need to turn on the keyboard. That would help. I am not ready for this, so this is a blooper. This will go in the vlog. This will be part of that vlog. Okay, I'm gonna practice, bye.
Train all my time. about 60 years.
Yay! My voice isn't exactly warm, but I figure I would do it while you were here and in a good mood. And had your coffee. You could have sat down, you know.
Did you, I told Mom about me and Bobby McGee.
What? What about me and Bobby McGee?
Well, that was a mom cast thing.
Well, Janis Joplin definitely sang.
Janis Joplin.
Yeah.
Had a USO show. It was the Vietnamese singers.
Oh, yeah. They were on the...
tour in Vietnam for the troops. And they came here to base camp, and I got the honor of driving them to different base camps around the area.
Yeah.
And this old gal sounded just like...
Janis Joplin?
Yeah. And so I rolled them up. They would perform, spend the night, and then I would take them to the next base camp. I rolled them up in the morning, and I said, okay, we can't start hear me and Bobby McGee.
Can't start the car until we play me and Bobby McGee.
Yeah.
But you had them singing it, yeah.
Yeah, I had her singing.
Yeah. And you had a lot of musicians piled in too, right?
Well, I would say there was 1, 2, 3, her papa's son.
Yeah.
And me, the driver.
Yeah.
And it's funny, we were going in a Jeep.
Yeah.
So we had 3 people in that little Jeep in the back.
Yeah.
Papa's son, well, her, sitting on the gear shift console.
Uh-huh.
And Papa's son, half his butt hanging out of the side
of the Jeep.
And young people pulled me over.
Yeah.
Said, where are you going? I told them what base camp I was going to and everything. I said, well, you can't go like that. And I said, what? And he said, it's unsafe.
Now they care about your safety, huh?
Yeah. And I said, well, we've been doing it for 2 or 3 days, you know. He said, I can't be.
Yeah.
If you run into trouble and you have to speed up or something, Papa's son fall out. And
yeah.
He said, you know, no seat belts or anything. I said, I got a rope right there.
Yeah. You must tie him up?
So we tied a rope around his side.
Oh, yeah, kind of like a makeshift door.
Yeah.
I
forgot her name, but I said, all right. We don't hit the road again, so I got to hear Bobby McGee.
Yeah,
there. I think that's the only song she knew. She didn't sing nothing else.
Oh, that was always me and Bobby McGee when she played the USO show.
Yeah.
Well, if you don't speak the language that well and you manage to memorize one song, you better sing it, and sing it well, and sing it all the time. Yeah. Do you want to play it again, Sam, or are you good?
I'm good right now.
Okay.
She said, do you ever come to Saigon? And I said, yeah. She said, I'd love for you to come down. She told me where the USO camp was. I took the guy to prison. One shotgun went down and met her there. She said, I know you want me to sing Bobby McGee.
Nice. Did you have a fling with this Bobby McGee girl?
No, I wouldn't call her a fling. She's a good friend.
A good friend. My goodness.